Dear students, I welcome you all to this first video lesson in the series of this e-learning in respect of computer science subject for class 12th. In this video, we will be discussing the chapter of file handling that is a part of unit first, that is computational thinking and programming part 2. File handling is mostly a practical concept, but before going to the practical sessions, we must be clear about the theoretical concepts of this file handling. So we will be discussing the theoretical points here, and after that we will be having a detailed practical session on this topic. Okay, so let's begin the chapter with the contents that are mentioned in the CBSE curriculum. So in this chapter you will be having the topics on need for the data file, then we will be discussing types of file, then the files will be discussed one by one. The first type of file is text file, and the operations on those files will also be discussed. Then we will be discussing binary files, and in the binary files we will be focusing on the Pickle module that is used to read and write the binary files. Then the operations on binary files will also be discussed, and at the end we will be having CSV file and the basic operation of reading and writing the CSV files. Okay, so this is the content of the chapter. So let's begin with the introduction part. File is a collection of bytes stored on some storage device. Files are actually used for permanent storage of data. You are familiar with the Python programming. In class 11th, you have done a lot of programming in Python, and there you must be knowing that whenever you type a program and then you run it, you have to provide the input again and again. You provide the input, you get the output, then you close the program. Then when you again run the program after some time, then you have to again enter the required input values. So this was the requirement for files. So in files, what we do is we can store our input data permanently, and we can use the same data again and again whenever we require it. Okay, that's why we use file handling. So files are permanent storage of data. They store our data, the values that we require, permanently, and these files are stored in some storage devices like hard disk. It can be a pen drive. Okay, so mostly in our for our computer system it is hard disk. So the previous type of programs that you have made in class 11th, you were using RAM, that is the volatile memory for storage of data, and that storage of data was till your program is finalized. As soon as you close your program, the execution is over, the values are not available in the RAM. So then you have to again type them when you rerun the program. But in the files, what we will be doing is we will be storing our values, and those values will be stored in a file that will be saved in hard disk. And whenever we want to use that file, suppose after one day or one month or one year, those contents will be there with us. So I think the concept of file handling is clear to you. So for example, if you have entered the details of 40 students in a class section and you just close the program and the contents are gone, and when you rerun the program, then you have to type those 40 records again, so it is very time consuming. And after two or three times, you will not put those values again, you will switch to some other softwares. So in files, what we will be doing is we will be storing those 40 records of the students in a file so that we can use them anytime. Clear? So this was the base of file handling. So this file handling concept reduces input of data from the user every time the program is executed, and the values entered previously by the user can be reused anytime. Then we come to the type of files. The first type is text file. The text file stores the information in ASCII or Unicode characters. You have studied about ASCII, that is American Standard Code for Information Interchange, and Unicode in class 11th, and you are well aware about that. In text file, each line of text is terminated with a special character that is called EOL character. Please pay attention, EOL means end of line. Okay, so whenever we end a line, a special character called EOL character will be used. Okay, so as this EOL is an external character, so some internal translation will take place whenever this character is read or written. Because this EOL character will be having a special significance. That is, we will be denoting the end of file using this character. So some internal translations take place when this EOL character is read from the file or written to the file. In Python, by default, this EOL character is taken as new line character, that is backslash n, or the combination of carriage return and new line. The second type of file is binary file. The binary file contains the information in the same format in which the information is stored in the memory, that is binary format, zeros and ones. And the advantage in binary files is that there is no delimiter for a line. We do not have to use any special EOL symbol to specify the end of line. As there is no EOL or special character involved in this, so no translation occurs in binary files. And when translation is not there, the data can be read or written more quickly compared to the text file. Okay, so binary files are faster and easier for a program to read and write. As long as the file doesn't need to be read by people or need to be ported to a different system, binary files are considered the best way to store a program information. As the contents of this binary file will be in 0 and 1, so these will be machine readable format. Okay, the text files are in human readable format, whereas the binary files are in machine readable format. So if you want to have a file that you wish to have in human readable format, then you should go for text file only. Similarly, if you want the file to be ported to a new operating system, then also you should go for text file, because binary file are system dependent, so they should not be used. But if you want faster mechanism for data accessing and you are not concerned with the readability by yourself, because the data will be read by the machine only, so you will go for binary files. Okay, the third type of file is CSV file. Here CSV stands for comma separated values, means a file that contains some values that are separated by a delimiter called comma. A CSV file is a human readable text file where each line has a number of fields separated by commas or some other delimiter. There can be other delimiter also. You can use colon sign or semicolon, but mostly comma is taken as default delimiter. Each line is considered as a row and each field is considered as a column. CSV format has no particular standard, but they are very much similar. To read and write CSV files, we have to use CSV module. Okay, so this module comes with the pre-installed Python that you have used in class 11th also. So this will be the CSV module will be imported when you will work with CSV file. Okay. Now let us see some basic operations that are possible on files. Some basic operations are opening of the file, closing of the file, reading data from a file, writing data to a file, appending data in a file. Appending means adding at the end. Searching data in a file. So if you have data, you will sometime many a times requires some searching also. That facility is also provided on files. Then modification of the data in file. Suppose you have entered something incorrect, then you can change those values using this facility. And deleting data from the file. So these are the some basic operations that are possible on files. So let's start with how to work on the files. So first and foremost thing is to open a file. Okay. Now try to understand the concept that the file is stored in hard disk and you are trying to read that file or write that file or you are trying to operate that file from your Python program. So these are two different entities. One entity is your Python program from where you are trying to control that file, and the second entity is the file that you have stored in your hard disk. Okay, so what you do is you require a connection between these two so that the data can be transferred from your Python program to the file or vice versa. Okay, it can be stored from your Python program to the file, or it can be the data can be retrieved from the file to your Python program. So both ways the data can be changed. So you require a connection that will connect your Python program with your file. Okay, so the first thing is you must know the name of the file that you are creating. If it is already existing, you must know its name, or if you are creating it, you should give it a proper name. In Python, we use open function to open a file. So let us see the syntax. Syntax is you will name a file object. This name should be according to the naming rules in Python. Then you will use the open function, and in open function you will be providing the name of the file that you want to open. The name will be provided in double quotes as it is a string. Second method is the file object. Then we use open method with two arguments. The first one is the name of the file, and second one is the mode in which you want to open the file. So we will be covering this second type of syntax later on, focusing on the file modes. But let us have some examples. Suppose we give the name of the file object as my file, and we have the file student.txt to be opened. So we will be writing my file is equal to open student.txt in double quotes as it is a string. So it will open the file that is stored in the hard disk, and a connection will be created between the Python program and the file. Second example, the name of file object taken as file2 is equal to open notes.txt is the name of the file, comma, the mode is specified as R. Okay, R represent reading mode. So modes will be discussed later on. So just have some look at this example, and both the arguments are given inside double quotes as they are string. To open a file that is present in a different folder than the directory in which the module file is located, we have to give the complete path of the file. Okay. Suppose you are working in some other directory and your file is stored in some other drive or in your pen drive, then you should be giving the complete path of the file that is to be opened. Okay, for example, if there is a folder called my folder in the D drive and the name of the file is result.txt, then how you will write? You will write file 3, that is the file handler, that is file object, is equal to open. Then in double quotes you will be providing the complete name of the complete path of the file, D colon double slash, that is backslash my folder double backslash result.txt. Okay, here we have used backslash, double backslash. As you know, backslash has a special meaning in Python. It converts it into a escape sequence. So if you want to avoid using this double backslash, why we have used double backslash? One backslash will suppress the value, the property of the backslash. The backslash has a special property of changing the character into a escape sequence. So using double backslash will suppress that property of backslash. But if you want to use only single backslash, then you should put R before the path. So this R makes this string as a raw string, and Python understands it that there is no special meaning attached to any character in this path. So you have two options: either use the path with double backslash or use R and give the path in single backslash. Okay, so these are the two types how you can give a path when you have to open or when you have to access a file that is stored somewhere else other than your current working directory. Now we have a second way of opening the file, that is using the with statement. So this with statement for files is very handy when we have two related operations which we would like to execute as a block. Okay, so let us go for a syntax. With, that is a keyword, then open is the function, then we will provide the name of the file, then we will provide the file mode, then we will have a special name called as, and then we will write the file object. So you can see the difference in the first open statement and this opening the file using with statement. So this with statement is having a block. Okay, you can see the with statement is ending with a colon sign. So whenever a statement is ending with a colon sign, that represents a start of the block. Then you will be having the file manipulation statements following this with statement. Okay, so there is a bit of difference. You will write with an open function, then you will provide the name of the file, then file mode, then you will write as, and then you will name the file object, then you will put a colon sign because you are signifying the start of a block. Okay, and after the start of the block you will provide the necessary file manipulation statements. The advantage of using this with statement with respect to the previous one is that it automatically closes the file after the nested block of code is executed. Okay, in the previous version of open, the file has to be closed by you, otherwise if you want to reopen it, it will generate error that the file is not being closed yet. But when you use this with statement, then Python automatically closes that file object at the end of these file manipulation statements. Okay, it is guaranteed to close the file no matter how the nested block exits. The block may exit with some errors, or it can exit without any error, that is after completing all the statements. So in both the cases the file will be closed, so you will not be able to access the file after these file statements. Okay, so if you want to access, then you have to reopen the file. Okay, so in the previous open statement you have to close the file, and how to close the file, that we will see in a few minutes, but the difference between these two opening methods is when we use with statement, then we do not worry about closing the file connection. It is automatically closed after the block of this with statement is terminated. Okay. If there is an exception, then also the file will be closed. So let's have a look at the file object. What is file object? We have used this name again and again in these 2-3 minutes. So a file object is a reference to the file stored on the disk. I have told you that a file is an external entity. It is stored somewhere else. Your Python program is a different entity. So you have to connect it. So the connection name is your file object that will connect your Python program to the file. It opens and makes the file available for a number of different tasks. File object, or it can be called file handle, is very important, as through this only a Python program can work with the files stored on the hardware. So there is no other way you can access the file. You can only access the file using a file object or a file handle. Okay, so you must have seen a cricket bat that has the handle on its top. So I think you have, many of you have used a bat while playing cricket. So when the handle gets off, it is very difficult to play cricket with that bat. I know many of you have tried it, but without the handle, it will be very difficult to play cricket with that bat that is not having the handle. Similarly, we will not be able to access the file if you do not have a file handler, that is a file handle. Okay. So when we open a file, Python stores a reference of the mentioned file in the file object. So the file object has the knowledge that I am here to connect to that specified file. Okay. If you have three files, then you have to create three different file objects. You cannot access the three files with the same file object, because each file object will be having information about that particular file to which it is connected. What is actually the file object? It is a stream of bytes where the data can be read byte by byte or line by line or as a whole. So you can consider it that there are two objects. One is your Python file, another is your file, and in between there lies a group of bytes which will carry the data from either your Python program to file or file to the Python program. Okay, it is like a pipe that is connecting two tanks from one the data is being transferred to another tank. Okay, so it is a collection of bytes. So like the pipe carries the water from one tank to another, similarly this file object will carry data from one entity to another. I think you are clear about the two entities. The two entities are, one entity is your program, Python program, another entity is your file. Okay, the name of the object has to be as per the naming rules in Python, that is for all the names that you give in Python. Okay, now we have discussed this file access mode many a times in this video, so we will be focusing now the what is file access mode and what different modes are there in Python so that we can access the file. So when Python file is opened, it needs to know the file mode in which the file is being opened. Okay, when you try to open the file, then the Python should be aware about the mode, in which mode you are opening the file. A file mode governs the type of operation that are possible on the open file. So all the modes have some specific operations that are allowed on them, and the rest of the operations are not allowed. So that's why we require the mode. If the mode is given, then you have some fixed operations to be done on that file. Okay, so it's like a constraint. Okay, so let's go to the modes that are possible in Python. So we are having two type of modes. One is text mode, another is binary mode. Okay, mostly the files can be categorized in these two basic categories. So text mode and binary mode. In binary mode, a character B is added to the text mode. Okay, so let us have a look. The first is R, then W, then A. Next we have the added variants of these three: R plus, W plus, A plus. Okay, R represents read, W represents write, A represents append. If you explain the word append, it is add at the end. Okay, add at the end becomes append. So there are three modes. Basically, these are read mode, write mode, append mode. And if we want to provide some extra facility with these modes, then we use plus sign. It becomes R plus, W plus, A plus. Similarly, if these modes are used with binary files, they are now RB, WB, AB. Okay, that means read binary file, write binary file, append binary file. Again, if we add some extra facility, then it becomes RB plus, WB plus, AB plus. Okay, so these are the three basic modes that are extended to the binary file, and we can also provide some extra facilities and we make it with a plus sign. Let us focus one by one. First, let us take R mode. It is read mode. In this mode, the file must be existing in your hard disk. If it is not existing, it will generate IO error, input output error. So if your file is already there, then you can use R mode or RB mode. Okay, now we come to the very important mode, that is W mode, write mode. It is very powerful. Why so? If the file is not existing in your system, it will create that file. First point. And if the file is existing, all its contents will be overwritten. That means that you will not be able to recover those contents. Those will be overwritten by the new contents. Actually, you can say that the original file will be deleted, its contents will be removed, and a new file will be created. Okay, so W mode is very dangerous. So whenever you want to open a file, be cautious while using W mode. For example, if you are having 1300 records of students of your whole school, and just you open that file in W mode, then all those records will be gone. Okay, so be cautious while using this W mode. Then we come to A mode. This A mode, if the file exists, then that data will be added at the end of that file. Or if the file is containing 100 records, then the next one will be written after that 100th record. Okay, that's the facility of A, that is append mode. If the file is not existing, the file will be created and that record will be entered. I think I am able to make it clear to you, all these three basic modes. Now we come to the advanced version of these. Plus. Plus means the facility that is lacking is added. That, for example, R is lacking writing facility. So plus adds a writing facility to it. W lacks reading facility. So W plus makes it read and write. Similarly with A plus also. So R plus, file must be existing, otherwise error is raised. That is the basic property of reading mode. And you can read and write, both the operations are allowed or then file. Similarly with W plus, file is not existing, it will be created because W is very powerful mode. Otherwise the contents are overwritten and you are allowed to read and write on that particular file. Similarly with A plus mode. So there are only three basic modes: R, W, A, read, write, append. And if you make some modification, then it becomes R plus, W plus, A plus. And if these six modes are applied to binary file, then character B is added to the modes. Okay, so you have to understand these file modes completely. otherwise there will be a problem when you will starting dealing with files. Okay, so W is the most dangerous mode. So whenever you are opening a file in W mode, you have to cross check it again. Okay, otherwise your contents will be lost. Okay, great. Now the last thing that has to be done in a file is closing it. So an open file is closed by calling the function close that through its file object. Everything is to be done through a file object, because that is the path connecting to the connecting the Python program with the file. A close function breaks the link of the file object and the file on the disk. So if you are done with everything on that file, then you cut that connection and the entities are now free. In Python, files are automatically closed at the end of the program, but it is a good practice to close your files by yourself. That is called explicitly. Okay, the operating system may not write the data out to the file until it is closed. Sometimes the operating system may not write that data in the file. It should be holding it somewhere in a buffer. Then if you just turn off the program, then that data will not be written in the file. It will be stored in a buffer. So you have to close the file by yourself. And when you write a close command, the operating system writes the data that is stored in that buffer, that is to be written in the file, that is completely stored in that file, and then the link of the file and the program is broken, and now both the entities are free. Okay, how you call it? With the file object, the name of the file object, and dot, then you use close function. Okay, if the name of the file object is my file, then the command will be my file dot close. Clear? So I think up to this all the concepts are clear to you. So this is the first part of this video lesson series on the topic of file handling, and in the next topic, in the next session, we will be discussing working with text file, binary files and CSV files in details, because you have to deal with them, then you have to take extra caution while dealing with all these three files. So we will be dealing with them in a separate lesson, so we can focus on each file separately. Okay, and after that we will be having practical sessions. Okay, so we will be meeting in the next video lesson.